With all of these derivatives floating around when we deal with inductors and capacitors, it's not always easy to find the voltage and the current in some of these circuits. We're going to look at a rather simple circuit right now and show that with only two circuit elements, that is, a resistor and a capacitor, it's already complicated. We're going to use this problem as motivation for a better method. The goal here is to find the voltage VC across the capacitor as a function of time. Let's label the current as I. This equation describes the voltage drop across that resistor. Furthermore, we know the relationship between current and voltage in a capacitor. Combining, we can eliminate the current I. We now have a bit of a problem. We have the voltage both inside of a derivative and outside of a derivative. This is a first order differential equation. One way to solve differential equations is to make a guess for the solution. I have a feeling that the frequency in this circuit is not going to change. I'm guessing that the voltage across the capacitor has some unknown amplitude A, which I intend to find, and although I expect it to have the same frequency as the source, I expect also that it might have some phase shift phi relative to the source that I also intend to find. I intend to substitute this expression of the voltage back into my differential equation and try to find A and phi. In order to do that, we need to calculate the derivative. I'm now going to use two trigonometric identities in order to separate the omega t term from the phi. I identify alpha as omega t and phi as beta. In the second equation, I identify alpha as omega t and beta as phi. Let's take these two expressions and substitute them into my differential equation. I'm going to divide every term in this equation by cosine of omega t. This means that this term, and this term will end up being tangent of omega t. Let's group those terms together first. For the first term, we're left with a times the cosine of phi. For the second term, we're just left with vm. And for the third term, we're left with RCA omega sine phi. Let's put the other two terms on the right side of the equation. The cosine will be canceled. So with the first term, we're just left with A sine phi. And for the second term, we're left with RCA omega cosine phi. This is an interesting expression because only the first term, this tangent of omega t, depends on time. These are all constants. The right side of the equation is also full of constants. There's no time dependence on the right side of the equation. The only way for this equation to work out is for both of these constants to be equal to zero. If they were not equal to zero, we would end up with a situation where something that depends on time equals something that is constant. That would force the time-dependent part of the equation to be zero. And we don't want that. We thus have two constants equal to zero, and this gives us two equations. The first equation allows us to determine A, and the second equation allows us to determine phi. Omega is 2 pi times the frequency. Plugging in those values, we find that phi is negative 32.14 degrees. From my first equation, I've uncovered an expression for A. Because I know V sub m, and I now know phi, R, C, and omega, I can find that A equals 0.847. I now know what the voltage across the capacitor is as a function of time. In general, the process that we just went through will work for any arbitrarily large circuit containing only resistors, capacitors, and inductors. We've assumed a form for the expression of the voltage. We've not altered the frequency at all, but we've added a phase angle to it that we then found. This is a really tricky way to do things. It involves very long algebraic expressions and a lot of work. Next, I'm going to describe how this can be done in a much simpler way using phasors. This video is part of an organized sequence where I explore various AC and switching circuits. If you enjoyed it, then you might consider following the channel's playlist to learn more about these types of circuits.